So how did you develop the toolbox?
Well, how I did it, I started with the toolbox in 1986 when I was on sabbatical at MIT. And the first years up to 2005, I did all the coding myself. Every single line was written by myself. And I had it as a hobby, doing it mostly on Saturdays when I had time off my regular job. So I wrote a big piece every Saturday, and the first version actually was finished in July 1986. So it has been, of course, been extended a number of times since then, basically by my hobby on Saturdays, adding functions one after the other.
Why did you partner with MathWorks for this tool?
Well, that is a clear story. I was on sabbatical at MIT, 1985 to 86, and I gave a graduate course on system identification at MIT in the spring of 1986. And I am a strong believer that the system identification must be taught together with clear hands-on experience with playing with real data and finding out how methods really work in practice. So I had written, well, MIT at the time had not let MATLAB, but I bought MATLAB to MIT in the early spring of 1986. And then I wrote some simple code pieces for ARCs, RMAX, etc., that the students could play with in my course during this spring course. And then I was called up by Jack Little, the president of MathWorks, said, hey, I hear that you're writing some code for identification. Couldn't you write a toolbox? See, at that time, there was only one toolbox to MATLAB, namely control toolbox. And Jack wanted to have a few more. So I said, no, I can't do that. It's too demanding. I'm not a programmer. I can't do that. But Jack persuaded me. So I finished the first version by July 1986. And then it has continued for almost 30 years right now.
Why did you write it in MATLAB, and what advantages does that provide?
Well, I learned programming through Algol courses when I was an undergraduate student. So Algol was my first programming language. Then I went on to Fortran. I did all my programming as a graduate student in Fortran. So I know all this link and all this thing when you set up Fortran programs. It was tedious most of the time. Then we got hold of PC MATLAB in the late 1984 or early 1985. And wrote simple things in MATLAB at that time. And I really caught. I said, never Fortran again. I will stick to this language. This is exactly what I need. Very, very simple programming and very powerful results because we have this engine of Limpack behind yourself.
What role has MATLAB played in facilitating the teaching and research of system identification?
Well, MATLAB is a very important teaching tool. And we use it in all kinds of our courses in our control group in Linköping. But I think it's especially for system identification, the fact that you can deal with real data on a, say, lab type basis in undergraduate education means a lot for you to pick up what is a real thing in essence with these methods. So running identification toolbox is an integral part of our undergraduate and graduate courses in system identification. I couldn't give a course without it. Also, when I give industrial courses, hands-on practice on the MATLAB toolbox is an important element.